Hello and welcome to Write Bus Life Coaching Channel. Have you ever come across a piece of advice you wish you'd known sooner? And what about all those pearls of wisdom from the training course that you attended but forgot all about a week after getting back into your daily routine? In this video, I've put together 12 top tips to discover or rediscover to boost your confidence and productivity. I'll be sharing these after the opening titles. In the meantime, are you on the right bus? Welcome back. We're talking all about life coaching. I'm Mervin Straughan, creator of the Three Journeys Life Coaching System, and I'm also the author of the self-help guide, Imagine Life as Three Bus Journeys. Now, there are some great pieces of advice and plenty of tools to use in the personal growth arena. So I've selected my top 12 tips to help you get the right results and feel more confident and effective, both personally and professionally. Here we go. Number one, have a life purpose. Purpose gives your life meaning. It affects how you view your job, your role in society, and your life as a whole. Studies show that people with purpose grow old in a more fulfilling way. It was Stephen Covey, the author of the international best-selling The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, who told us that while it's okay to retire from a job, it's vital we continue to make extremely meaningful contributions to life. Number two, your subconscious is always listening. Your subconscious mind is alert 24/7, always listening for your next command. While your conscious is the driver, your subconscious is the engine. And get this, it's unable to take a joke and stores everything and acts upon it. So make sure you give it good instructions and do avoid any self-talk that damages and demeans your capabilities. Number three, spend as much time as possible living in the present. Avoid sleepwalking through life because you're fixated by the past, and avoid wishing your life away because you're racing towards the future. By all means, take what you can from the lessons that the past has taught you and continue to plan for the future, but make sure that the major part of your life is lived in the present. Living in the present makes you conscious of everything you're experiencing. So pause and take in the beauty of nature around you and the kind actions of others. Be in the present when you eat. That means eating slowly and using all your senses to enjoy your meal. Number four, gratitude, and this is a biggie. Being thankful for what you have, no matter how small, affects how you feel. Each time you're grateful, it moves you to a more positive state. It's also good for your well-being and it helps to build resilience. Number five, and speaking of resilience, develop a growth mindset. When you encounter a setback, ask yourself, what can I learn from this? This is one of the components of personal grit, which research by US psychologist Angela Duckworth says is the best predictor of success in life. Can you believe that grit is more powerful than IQ and natural talent for getting you to where you want to be? Number six, surround yourself with the right people. It was the late great business expert Jim Rohn who said, "You're the average of the five people you spend most time with." Whether we like it or not, we're influenced by those closest to us. They have an influence on our confidence and self-belief, as well as our decision-making. We need to surround ourselves with people who believe in us and want us to succeed. And we need constructive feedback and a few reality checks every now and again. It's useful then to do an audit of those we spend most time with, and to gauge what influence they're having on us. Number seven, remember happiness is a byproduct rather than a goal. As the Greek philosopher Aristotle told us, it's a byproduct of how we live our life. To live life well, we need to live our purpose and develop as we make our journey and rise to the various challenges that life throws at us. The risk of making happiness the goal is that it might lead us to take the easy ride, thereby missing out on the challenges that force us to strive and grow as individuals. Number 8, be proactive. If you're stalling on a course of action, draw two columns on a sheet of paper. Label one, the prize for taking action, and the other, the price for inaction. Sometimes the prize will be a big one, and sadly, sometimes the price for doing nothing will also be big. Yes, there'll be occasions when doing nothing is the right option because you're waiting for more facts and for a clearer picture to emerge. However, in most cases, fortune favours the brave. Number 9, clear the clutter. There are practical and psychological reasons to avoid clutter. For one, the extra effort to find something simply slows you down, and in extreme cases, it poses a health and safety risk. As for psychologically, well, each of these items is making demands on your attention and energy. Some will leave you stuck in the past. If you have a basement or an attic or both, pay attention. As some experts say, these represent your past and your aspirations, respectively. So, if your basement is crammed, you're stuck in the past. And if your attic is crammed, your aspirations are being stifled. Get rid of the stuff you don't need in a responsible manner and reduce what comes into your home. Only bring something new into your home if it's useful or beautiful. Number 10, forget about multitasking. It doesn't work. Brain science studies show we don't actually multitask. All that's happening is our brain is switching between the tasks that are competing for its attention. The brain has to take stock before starting a task, so it just means you're slowing yourself down. In fact, some studies say that multitasking adds as much as 40% extra time to what we're doing. It's a known goal. Number 11, get your dreams and ideas out of your head and onto paper so you can take stock of them all. Sometimes we forget just what's buried inside of our heads. Miller's Law, named after the psychologist George Miller, states that we can only hold on average 7 items in our short-term memory, so it's little surprise that a lot of stuff gets buried. Life coaching clients often marvel at their long list of goals that they'd forgotten all about until we got them to write them down on a load of post-it notes. And when it comes to goals, if they're not written down, they're just dreams. Number 12, and on the subject of getting things out of your head, write them down with a pen, pencil, or a stylus rather than typing them on your keyboard. Research shows that handwriting helps us to retain and retrieve knowledge more effectively. The action of writing forces the brain to slow down and to give more time to what's being written and to make links between pieces of information. So while typing might give you the edge in a speed contest, handwriting will make sure it's stored and recalled much better. Well, there you have it, my top 12 tips for greater confidence and productivity. There'll be plenty more in future videos, so do keep tuned. If you've enjoyed the video, give it a like, and better still, remember to press the subscribe button so we continue to provide meaningful content and so that you're alerted to any new material. In the meantime, enjoy the journey.